been at this Carolina venture now for, well, going on 16 years, almost 17 years. Began with some reunion dates for the Melody Masters. And then about 2006, we decided to take a slightly different direction in our music, be a little bit more country gospel.
Amen.
And so Carolina Quartet was born. There had been a group on the radio when I was growing up in Asheville, North Carolina, called the Carolina Quartet. That name wasn't being used. You remember there was a period of time when the Kingsmen were known after the Kingsmen and before the Kingsmen Quartet. They were known as the Carolina Boys. There was a group in upstate South Carolina called the Carolina Boys. We didn't mean to be in competition with them in any way, but we checked it out. Carolina Quartet was available, so we took it. So 2006, Carolina Quartet was born with a new bass singer, a guy named Lamar Levi, stepping in to fill Richard Sanders' position, and then Roger stayed at the baritone, Scott was lead, I was tenor, and so for many, many years, we sung as Carolina Quartet. We did probably 30 dates a year, paid tribute to the Oaks, did some of our own material. It was just a great season, a great season. As you know, Roger had a heart attack, had major heart surgery, and over a period of time, he just felt like that maybe with the direction Carolina was going and the need for us to push it on out there a little bit, maybe his season had come to an end. He honored us, we honored him, and we remain friends to this day, and that's the way it should be.
Amen.
And so Roger and Nell are here tonight.
Woo!
Stand up, Nell. There's Nell Burnett. And here he is, folks. How about a good hand for Roger Philip Burnett? Did a lot of songs when he was with us, but there was one that people asked for almost every night, and it just fit him so perfectly. His personality, you know, Bakersville and Spruce Pine, North Carolina, both claim Roger. Bakersville claims he's from Spruce Pine, and Spruce Pine claims he's from Bakersville, and that's up there in the mountain area, and so this song right here just fit Roger's personality perfectly. Guys, it's in the key of G. We don't have a chord sheet on it. Just hang on as best you can. The song is called That Old Gravel Road.
Thank you.
have the breath he used to have.
Let me talk a little bit. There's a little story goes behind this country style singing. When I was a young boy, I was raised on a farm, and the hens started cackling down in the barn. And Daddy sent us down there to get the eggs. Well, me and my little brother's about that high. We went down there to get those eggs, climbed up the stairway to the barn, and the hen was over there on the nest and wouldn't get off. I got a pitchfork and lifted her up a little bit. Biggest old black snake you ever saw in your life was under that hen. And I told my little brother, I said, David, go over there and get that hen off that nest. He said, I ain't gonna do it. I said, well, I'm gonna jump out of the barn and commit suicide. You know what he said? I don't care.
Since you told one about David, your little brother, I'm going to tell one about David, okay?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Roger was about to the age that he wanted to start courting. And there was a young lady up there around Bakersville, Spruce Pine, that he was just infatuated with. And so he wanted to spend some time with her. But Roger was very spiritually minded young boy, and he didn't want to do anything that wasn't right. So he went to his dad. Roger's dad's just one of the greatest men in all the world. If you wonder what Roger's dad would have been like, that's it right there. I mean, it's just, Roger is just, he's honored his dad so much with his life. Roger's dad, a very spiritual man, so he went to his dad and said, Daddy, I'm interested in this little girl. Said, what happens when you get around her and you kind of get out of breath and you get a little frog in your throat and your hands get real sweaty? He said, Daddy, what's going on there? Roger's dad said, well, son, that's just part of growing up. That's part of, you know, learning about yourself. And he said, it's okay, you know, you'll get over it. You'll be able to get around girls and not get so out of breath and your throat get dry and your hands get sweaty. And he said, well, Daddy, let me ask you something else. He said, is it okay to kiss the little girl? Well, Roger's dad is a very spiritual, very, very Bible-minded man. He looked at Roger and said, well, I'll tell you what, son. If you're in doubt, just ask the Lord about it. The Lord will give you the answer. Roger thought it's pretty good, okay? So he made arrangements to go meet this little girl. And they were going to meet under this big oak tree, kind of near where their property was going again. But what Roger didn't know was his little brother David was listening in on that conversation. He got out in front of him and climbed up in that tree. So Roger and the little girl met. And they're talking, you know, the sun's going down, it's getting dark, they know they need to part ways for the evening. So, and Roger, he wanted to kiss this little girl so bad he could hardly stand. And he was just about ready to kiss her. And he looked up and he said, Father, Father up above, is it wrong to kiss the one you love? David was still up in that tree. He looked down at Roger and said, sinner, sinner down below, pucker up and let her go.